Thank you. Wonderful things. I am envious of how easy you make this look. Like, I've been working on that since I was 16, and I think once I played it in tune. I don't know, maybe once. Anyway, great job. I mean, it's not a theme. A little bit of what's gone on today is that to make more sound. I think the tendency is to push the sound out instead of to pull it out. And so what happens is that it becomes harsh instead of expanded, or instead of more resonant. And so I think that that's something that we can work on too. If you press, it gets a little pressed. It gets a little, but if you start in the middle of the bow and use more bow so that by here you're singing. Yeah, but don't peak too soon. It's so much more beautiful than it is if it's sort of being, you know, combatant.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think that's true sort of throughout the movement. There are so many places where things can be made easier by distributing the bow a little bit differently. Okay. This can also happen by starting in the middle of the bow and each two notes. You expanding the bow use. Yeah. So you're relaxing, hard to say, hard to do, but you're actually relaxing as you're going up rather than getting tense, right? Yeah, do it slowly. So you're really measuring. So you're singing on that top note,
mm-hmm,
right?
Mm-hmm.
Rather than, you know, breathlessly arriving there. Yeah. So you come on top of that, but the connect. So you feel you're going underneath and rising to it. Like that, and then when you have, yeah, so you're sort of skipping to it, right? Yeah. So, carefully let your bow lead the shift. That's right. Good. So that it meets, your left hand meets the bow. Mm-hmm. Right. Okay. Couple of things there. So let's start at the beginning. Okay. All right. Times in a row we have a B, mm-hmm. right? What's different about each of them? How did the first two bars relate to the third bar? Right, yeah. Right, so you know, it's a reflection. Now this is going rather than, it's not the same. And what's the dynamic at the beginning?
Fourth.
Yeah, okay, and what's it the second time? Right? Gotta save something.
Yeah?
Direction, but yeah, I think that okay. You should keep the rhythmic motive intact.
Okay.
Yeah. So a little more like this. Just la da ba bum ba bum. Right. Just keep that rhythm. But do you think, as you're listening, you could also make a line? And especially here. So you're actually bringing yourself to the amoeba. Yeah. And I think this, you're actually playing piano, and that's so rare, and I love that. It really, most people don't do that, so it's great. Great that you're doing that. But this, it's a Dvorak trademark, right? I think you should have that in there. That you should feel that. Yeah, a little more. So the phrasing is not. It's not from there, but. Right. So it goes through the scale. That's right. Yeah. Yeah, it's more fluid that way. Uh-huh. Rather than it being from beats, it's from the middle of the beat going on to the next. Yeah. Yeah, the bebo. And could you try actually moving the bow on the shift? Because the swell goes to the top, yeah. I can tell you that you have to just play with the orchestra here. Mm-hmm. when we do, just do the accents. Yeah, don't worry about being too expressive because they're going yum ba dum ba dum ba dum, and if you go ta da da da, but they're going to be like a mile ahead of you. And, yeah. Yeah. Don't come down too much because there's a long way, but do come down a little bit. Thoughts about the rhythm of this, right? Because again, when you're, to be expressive, you can stretch things, but there has to be a relationship to what they're coming from and where they're going. So certain note, you can't pick a note, like we call that picking a daisy. So you're just like picking a daisy. Oh, here's another one, you know. So we do that, but to stay with an idea of the. Of the half bar, right? So, the half bar here, right? So you react to where it is, rather than, so you kind of take your time, right? But whereas it doesn't have a rhythmic relationship to what the orchestra is doing, and I think that's not a good idea. Right. You have to have one. Yeah. So try that. For me, this gets a little. Always keep the half bar in mind. Because you do it, and then you go, and then you
A little bit intentional. I want it to vary each one, but I guess I don't want it to be dry on some. And,
I don't know. I would think about that a little bit. Because what's interesting is to whoop it out. Yeah. I wish you were more a little bit more like the horns. Not too short. Thank you. The sforzando. Yeah, it's there. On there. Recognize that motive? Yeah. I think, yeah, you want one thing down. Okay, so if we just skip to the next theme, which the dynamic is here? Really? Well, that would explain. Yeah, it is a little strange. Huh. And that's in the Czech edition? Or it's.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Huh. Okay. Still think it could be softer, yeah. Yeah. And a little more calm, but remembering that half bar. Right. And it's always coming back to the A flat, right? So you want to keep that tone on the A flat. And now you start moving away from it. And then the crescendo is here. I would play the whole thing, even though it does swell to forte, I would keep it on the intimate side. Yeah. Wonderful, beautiful fingering, but make the color more extraordinary. I think it's going to be, that's, you know, do something really special with it rather than just make the same sound. Yeah. It's just getting a little too stretched out rhythmically. So nobody else is playing. Yeah, do whatever you want. Take a moment, because here you're really just accompaniment. And then disappear again. Thank you. you don't really, since you play it like fine, it's nothing really much to suggest. But I would start in the middle of the bow again, and for this shift, move the bow each time. It makes the shifts a little easier. So you're exaggerating. Right. So also gives it, you're playing it very articulately, which is it was good, but I think it could have a little more sweep, you know. And then finally the whole bow. Right, so you really are free with the sound then. Good place to stop, right? That's great. Very good.
Let's thank Marcy Rosen for having us.